There are several athletes in Tar Heel history who've had famous sports dads.
Brian McIntosh introduces us to a track standout whose father is an NBA record holder.
Open Chicago with
the flu
lead.
Game.
Pass comes into Jordan. Here's
the
Mike
shot.
At the foul line. A shot on Elo. Good.
All prominent moments in NBA playoff history. However, the most spectacular one might have come on May 11th, 1987, where Eric "Sleepy" Floyd dropped 29 points on Magic Johnson and the Lakers in the fourth quarter, scoring a total of 51 for the night.
Come the end of the third quarter, they up by 14, and they're talking a lot of trash, one of the biggest trash-talking teams in the league. So just got fed up with it, and I made a decision in my mind, and also physically, just to take over the game and let them know if I wanted to do this, I could.
And Floyd did just that, setting an NBA playoff record with 29 points in one quarter that still stands today, making Eric "Sleepy" Floyd a household name. Just like that night against the Lakers, Floyd was pretty much the underdog his whole career, fighting to prove he belonged in the league, much like his daughter and Tar Heels' own, Corey Floyd.
He kind of helped me stick with track when I was at my lowest because he understands the struggles between a relationship between your coach and he understands long practice days, and he gets the, you know, having to travel all the time, having to sacrifice.
Just like her dad, Corey had her very own sleepy game.
It was the ACC competition, and they had put me in the 4x4. And we were ridiculously behind. Once the baton got to me, I made that decision that I was going to do whatever I could to kind of get back in the race.
Corey ran her personal best 55 seconds flat in the 400, nearly bringing her team to a comeback win.
Oh, it feels so good.
Just like her dad, Corey hopes to leave her mark. And this Tar Heel is wide awake. In Chapel Hill, I'm Brian McIntosh reporting.